Hello everyone, Treecks here and welcome to the final part of Kirby Super Star. Last time we finished the game, officially. We beat the final boss and we beat the final game and we got the end credits and everything. There is only one problem with that, namely the moment you clear Milky Way Wishes, the final game that you can unlock and therefore the final mini game that you can clear, you will actually unlock another one. The arena is up next. And it's not really a surprise why this is the true final game. You can basically only play this once you have cleared everything else, because this one is kind of like all of the Kirby games have from Kirby's Dream Land 2 and onward. The boss rush of this game. All of the bosses we have faced so far in one go. The final challenge. In his toughest battle yet, the Pink Wanderer faces his strongest enemies. And that includes the final boss and everything, and therefore this has to be after Milky Way Wishes. Get it? But anyway, the arena. The only way to finish off a Kirby game. Ever since Kirby's Dream Land 2, this is a standard in all of the Kirby platformers. And why the hell would Kirby Superstar be not a part of it? Well, I have news for you, it is a part of it. The arena will actually make us go through all of the bosses in this game. Even though Milky Way Wishes also did a pretty good job on that, because of having all these bosses at the end of the levels. But in this case, we have to do it all with one health bar, of course. Just like in Kirby's Dream Land 2 and 3. One health bar, all bosses. There are a couple of healing capabilities every once in a while, but for the most part, we're doing this with one health bar. Before we get started, we're thrown into a copy ability room. As you can see, we can choose whatever copy ability we want. Every single one is present here, including sleep and copy. The only ones we don't find here are the one-offs. So we don't find any crash or cook or paint or mic. But everything that has multi-use, you can find here. And I feel plasma is actually the best way to go in this game for the boss rush. And allow me to show you why. Plasma is by far the best copy ability to use from a distance. It is really easily charged. Just press left and right a couple of times. If you're good with your D-pad, you can quickly charge a move. And you can do a move that goes across the entire screen. And therefore saying you can defeat bosses from a safe distance. There are of course multiple strategies that you can use. But I feel this one is the safest, and in most of the Kirby games that have plasma, I feel plasma is the safest way to take on all of the bosses. They are random, by the way, the order you do them in is not set, like in Kirby's Dream Land 2 and 3. They're randomly given to you, and this first one is actually a mini-boss gauntlet. Even the mini-bosses are present here, as you can see. You don't get all of them in one battle, but there are a couple of mini-boss gauntlets that give you 3 mini-bosses. In this case, Cook Kawasaki, a Bunkers, and a Bugsy, as you can see. They all share the same health bar, as you can see to the bottom right of the screen. All of the bosses are part of the same health bar, so you know when you've defeated all of them. And once you do, the screen ends, we move on to the rest area, which will show you off how many bosses you have yet to do. In this case, 18. What the next boss coming up is. And it will give you the ability to grab some Maxim tomatoes. Do save them up, because they don't return the next time you're here. Once you have grabbed a Maxim tomato, it will stay gone until the end. So don't think you have 5 healing abilities every single boss. No, this is for the total round. So only grab them if you really feel like you're about to die, or you see a boss coming up that you're really afraid of. Oh, dang it. Okay, that was very wasteful. But I'm also not really surprised, because Combo Cannon, I really hate that guy, especially because of the stupid hand. But this is a very clear example of why plasma is so good. You can easily hit the main cannon with it, even from a safe distance. And let's move on to Wispy Woods, the easiest boss in this game. He's not the first boss for nothing. The Spring Breeze Stage 1 boss. Careful for the apples, because plasma or not, the apples can still reach you. This is one of the few bosses where I feel plasma does not really help all that much, because the boss can't move anyway, so... It's usually because of the movement for the boss that you want to stay away from them. In the case of Wispy Woods, that won't help you. And in fact, when it comes to Halbert's reactor, this guy, plasma also doesn't help, of course. Since we can't hit him with copy abilities. Careful for the fire. Should listen to my own advice. Okay. Let's fly around in front of the reactor. Okay, more fire incoming. Pretty hard to avoid in all honesty. And there we go. Next up is Fatty Whale. More plasma. Really like when the game gives you a statue of an ability you already have. But yeah, that's also a thing in the arena, as you can see. It even takes into account the fact that you can lose your ability in the middle of a boss fight, because as you may know, the moment you are hit, you actually have a chance of losing your ability. That is not different in this mode, so in case you are left without an ability, in the rest area you have the option to grab a new one. Two random abilities will get selected each time. You have an option to grab a power-up back. Just remember, the two statues that appear after each boss are random. It's not like it's the same two every single time or the same ones after every single boss. It is randomized. In this case, hammer and stone, as you can see. But okay, the most fun and hard boss in the boss rush is actually this one, as you can see. Looks like to be a Waddle Dee, but it is actually the hardest boss in this game. Wait for it. It's a Waddle Dee! Help! He's way too dangerous! There's no way we can ever win from this guy! Yeah, in all honesty, this guy's here because of the game thinking it's funny. Although this guy does take a lot more hits than normal Waddle Dee, so he's definitely the most powerful Waddle Dee in existence. But still, he does nothing and therefore it's really easy to defeat. Let's move on to more serious business. The Twin Woods fight. The Double Wispy Woods. From the first stage of Revenge of Meta Knight. And of course also the boss of Floria in Milky Way Wishes. Another boss where I don't really feel plasma helps a lot. But for most bosses, plasma works, so it's still the best power-up to go for. But I have to be honest, in not every single boss fight, plasma is the best power-up to have. But if you want to use it for most of the bosses, then all of the other bosses that are not really the best to use plasma, you're still going to have to work with it. But that will apply to any copy ability you choose to go this to do this with. Because of course you're not... Come on! Let go! Well, at least I live. I do feel my first Maxim Tomatoes coming up soon. Okay, let's try to finish that story. Of course, I'm playing with plasma right now because of me feeling that works the best for this entire mode. But if you have a different ability you think works best, of course you can play another one. But even for any other you choose, no power-up is the best against every single boss. Just take that in account. Okay, for computer virus, I think any ability works best, because this guy is just pathetically easy. Just remember, like I explained last time, the moment he attacks, just defend, no matter what he does. When you get a chance to attack, just attack. You don't have to worry about the enemy attacking you, because as you can see, he'll just stand there and do nothing. Pretty much impossible to get hit by this guy. Even though some moves do some slight damage, as you can see, even if you block, but never really too high numbers. Even the strongest attacks, whenever you are shielding, will do very minimal damage. And most of the attacks these guys can do actually do no damage, so... As you can see here. So the computer virus should be really easy to do. If you just remember to shield the moment the enemy's turn is and whenever your turn is, just attack. And be careful not to touch the enemy, of course, because you can still get hurt by touching the enemy. Also a reason why you should using plasma, so you don't have to stand close to them. Okay, next up is Meta Knight, and that one I think is one of the hardest bosses in this game, so I really like to be full health here. Meta Knight, I really feel, is one of the hardest bosses in this game when it comes to not getting hit. Okay, let me show you off another trick involving Meta Knight. The game always tries to force you to grab sword, because of the game wanting this to be a sword fight. But let me tell you that you don't have to. If you just wait long enough, the fight will still start. You are actually not forced to grab sword. The game just wants you to think you are. It's a very wise idea not to do it, because sword, as fun as it is, it does force you to go up close and personal to this guy, and since of his aggressive and erratic moveset, it is pretty easy to get hit with sword. So I'd like to be as far away from him as possible, and plasma allows me to do it. And even then I get hit a couple of times. Okay, that could have been worse. I actually remember a couple of tries where I actually lost this guy with the full health bar. That's how annoying he can be, but this time I only got hit twice, so should be able to reach the end now. 9 more bosses to go, and we have Heavy Lobster next. Also a boss where it really is advised to stay away from him. Just move to the other side of the screen. Try to attack him. Because for this guy, it also feels like getting up close and personal just means you get hit a lot. So stay away from him. Oh, and that ball attack he just did, the paintball, can actually also give you paintability. It's a pretty rare attack, but it's actually also a way you can get paintability in this game. Didn't come up yet, so it kind of slipped my mind, but even Heavy Lobster can give you paintability. It's not exclusive to Chameleon Arm, but Heavy Lobster actually also has a move that can give it. Luckily, he showed it off last minute. It's the last time we're going to see him, but he managed to show it off last time, so I got reminded by that. Okay, Lolo and La 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 are something we're not going even to talk about. Let's get rid of them quickly. 7 more bosses to go. Still 4 maximum tomatoes, so we're doing fine. Wham Bam Rock is up next. And still feel plasma is the best way to go. As I was saying, this boss rush is randomized. It's actually random in which order all of the bosses appear in. But that's not really true, because there's one boss that's actually always the final one. The final boss, Marx. Of course, he's always the final one, so it's not entirely randomized, you might say. But all of the other bosses are. All of the other bosses can appear in any order. So I'm fighting Wham Bam Rock now, and next time I'll try, he might even be the first one. It's also one of the aspects that makes the arena really awesome in this game. The fact that all of the bosses appear in random order, and not always the same from start to finish. First boss first, second boss second, third boss third. Kind of the way the Kirby Dream Land series works. Also interesting, but also becomes kind of boring and repetitive if you have to do it multiple times. Okay, let's not lose my plasma. It's one of the things that can really break this attempt at the arena. If I lose my plasma halfway through this. No, come on. Come on, DDD, you're a spring breeze boss and I am almost losing to you. I am ashamed. Okay, next mini boss gauntlet is coming up, but I feel like my health is getting a little low, so with 5 more bosses to go and 3 more maximum tomatoes, I still feel like I'm on schedule. It would also feel like a waste if I have maximum tomatoes left the moment this ends, so might as well use them now the end is coming closer. There's still 2 more bosses I can think of that might come a little bit tricky. Chameleon Arm is one of them. It's also a boss that I usually get hit by, so with the help of a shooter right away. sometimes hitting the D-pad left and right so oftenly in order to charge up your move makes me face the wrong direction. Because of course you use the D-pad for that as well. No, not necessary. No, don't you dare. Bam, done. Next one. Oh yeah, Krakko. Kind of forgot that guy. For some reason I never am able to remind myself of the Spring Breeze bosses. Spring Breeze is such a short and early game that I always forget the bosses in there. Lololo and Lalala is also always one that slips my mind. Usually I only remember the DDD fight because of that one being the final one. But Krakko is also a thing, of course. I'm getting a little bit sloppy now. It's probably because of me reaching the end now. And having the stupid idea that I have enough Maxim Tomatoes left in order to make this easy. Makes me a little bit careless. Chameleon Arm. Okay, that guy I'm a little bit too afraid of, so let's grab myself a Maxim Tomato. And there's three bosses with three tomatoes left, so it's even advised to grab a Maxim Tomato after every boss fight now. Otherwise, we're indeed going to have one left. Okay, Gamedio Arm. Not really that hard of a boss, but for some reason I always manage to get hit by him at least once. But I have my plasma, so I should be able to stay away from him and be on a safe distance for his tongue and his legs. His long distance attacks. Usually the reason why I get hit by him, because of his long distance, long range attacks. But I have one of my own. So unable to do him without getting hit. Okay, next one that I was thinking of that usually gets me, Heart of Nova. Not a very hard boss, that is not the problem. Just doing this without getting hit usually is tricky. And what am I saying, him not being a hard boss? He is a heart. With E-A-R-T and not A-R-D. A hard heart. But okay. Okay, only got hit once. And with that, we only have one more. Final boss remaining is, in fact, the final boss, like I promised. Marx is always the final boss, no matter what. Very suiting, even in the arena, the final boss is the final boss. And I have a full health bar to do it, and even some plasma to make it a little bit easier, since I don't have to come near him. I can monitor his every movement from a safe distance. If I screw this up, I should be ashamed of myself. Already more than halfway dead, so doing fine. He has only hit me once so far. This is in the bag. Oh. I sometimes always feel even if he's teleporting you can still hit him, but that's actually not the case. Whenever he's teleporting around, he's invulnerable. Nope. Did not expect you there. But I have plenty of health, so not too worried. You do have a tendency to spawn inside of me all of a sudden. I should be careful now, because he's almost dead. But I'm also losing health quickly now. Okay, there we go. I was about to say it would be very wasteful if I screw this up, but luckily I didn't. And there we go, that is the arena. All of the boss fights in a row with one health bar and limited healing abilities. Just like in any other Kirby game, that is a thing, as you can see. The game keeps track of your best time. That's basically the way to high score this. How fast can you do it? In my case, 12 minutes. 12 seconds, 77 milliseconds. Not a very amazing time, but I'm not doing this to create a very great time. This is just to clear things off, to say I've 100%ed this game. And with this, we have done so. Even the arena will unlock you something. Don't worry, it's not another new mini game. There's no new bonus content coming up. This is actually the music / sound test for this game. And that is the final thing to unlock. All of the music in the game available on demand. So you can listen to any of the great songs from this game at any point you want, with a single click of a button. Sound effects too, a little bit less interesting you might say, but it is always a standard thing in Hell Laboratory games that there's always a music and sound effects option available. In this game, and that is also the case, but you can only unlock it once you've beaten every single thing in this game, as you can see. So, with that said, that is actually all. That is Kirby Super Star. There's nothing in this game anymore I have to cover. So, another Kirby game can be scratched. This project is now concluded. The next project is going to start next week. I am not sure which one that is. I do have a candidate, but I'm not really sure if I want to play that now already. So I can't really help you on the next project. You're going to have to wait until Monday for that. So, I will see you folks then, or any other project. Just click whatever you want to see. That's what all these videos are for. This is Kirby Superstar, at least, so if you've been watching through the entire thing, thank you for joining me on this journey through one of the best Kirby games ever made. So, all I can say is, Treecks out.